Hello everyone and welcome to the session. This session is all about cables and connector. As you know, current flows. But current needs something to flow through and that are cables. So, let's get started. Cables are very important in PV system because cable interconnects PV solar panel and other components of photovoltaic system. For example, cables are used to connect solar panel to inverter, where we use DC cable. On the other hand, AC cable is used to connect inverter to the grid or load. You can find cable and wires everywhere because electricity has reached in every corner of your house. Talking about the properties of cable used in solar PV system, cable should be designed to be UV and weather resistance. UV is ultraviolet radiation. Cable should be flexible and flame retardant. Cable should have long service life. They must be extremely rugged and should be resistant to oil, heat, corrosion and weathering. These properties are required because generally solar cables are laid outside. Coming to the types of cable, in solar PV system there are AC and DC cable. Based on conductor material, cable can have copper or aluminium conductor, but copper is preferred the most because it is more conductive than aluminium. Cables can be single core, double core, three core or multi core. Based on the application of cable, can be single stranded or multi stranded. Here is the images available with you so you can see it easily. Based on the application, there are several types of cable available in the market. The size of the cables are available in AWG, that is American wire gauge. As you increase the gauge, the size decreases. On the other hand, we have another size of cable, which is in square millimeter, like 4 square millimeter, 6 square millimeter, etc., referring to the area of cable. These are the specification of DC polycap cable. As you can see, in the construction characteristics, there is an outer sheath, there is an insulation, and after that you can find the copper conductor, stranded tin copper conductor. These cables are generally used in solar application. There is a cross link halogen free and flame retardant insulation and sheath. You can see the electrical characteristics, which are showing the rated voltage and rated DC voltage, which is 1.5 kV. Working DC voltage is 1000 volt, so it is recommended that your system voltage should not be more than 1000 volt. Cables are color coded. Red refers to positive or live. On the other hand, black color refers to negative or neutral. Earthing cable is coded with green color. In three phase RYB phases are coded with respective red, yellow and blue color. Coming to the very important property of the cable, which is ampacity. Ampacity is the current carrying capacity of the cable, which is rated in ampere. So, as you can see in the table, I am taking one example of 4 square mm cable, which is commonly used in solar PV system. So, 4 square mm cable can carry a current of 55 ampere in air, 52 amperes on surface and 44 ampere if two adjacent tables are on surface. So, while selecting the cable size, it is always recommended to oversize the cable for safety purpose. We will learn that in solar PV system designing chapter. The resistance of the cable is also given, which is used for calculating voltage drop and losses in the cable. You can find specification of ampacity like this in DC as well as in AC cable. It varies with every type of cable. While laying and routing of cable, it is not acceptable to keep the cables open. So, cables are laid in cable conduits such that cable will be prevented from the rodents like rat. It is obvious that you don't want wires and cables hanging in your home. So, cable trays and conduits pipe are used to make aesthetic good and hiding those cable. In underground laying of cable, cable conduits are given more attention because cable have to withstand extreme pressure underground. Coming to the next topic, which is connector. You might be remembering there are MC4 connector, connected to solar panel. So in solar system, MC4 connector are used to interconnect the panel. MC4 connector are also provided with inverter. So MC4 connector are used to connect output terminal of solar panel to the inverter input terminal. The name MC4 connector came from multi-contact company which firstly developed this type of connector. The number 4 indicates its size, that's 4 mm. MC4 connector came in pair, which are female MC4 connector and male MC4 connector. Female is positive terminal and male is negative terminal. They interlock when connected to each other. MC4 connector are UV protected and having IP68 rating, so they are waterproof and dustproof. Here, you can see various components of MC4 connector. First is end cap, then strain relief, then compressive sleeve, which hold the input cable, followed by coupler body. We have male and female pin. Input cable gets attached to this pin and pin looks in a coupler body. Then you are ready to interconnect solar panel in series and parallel. There are also Y-type and T-type branch connector, which is used for single input and two output application, or for connecting panels in parallel. As I said, MC4 connector are waterproof and dustproof, hence they are very easy to use. As you can see in this image, we can connect panel in series by just inserting the male connector to the female connector. That's look easy. So that's all about MC4 connector is. Finally, came to an end of the session, in which we learnt about cable, types of cable, DC cable, the most important, ampacity. Then we have learnt about the cable conduit and cable trays, and last but not least, about MC4 connector. I have taken reference from Polycap solar cable datasheet. So, if you want to explore more, you can download it from Polycap website. This is your Google assignment. Find the difference between AC and DC cable. Although we use only MC4 connector in solar, find more types of connector and find out famous cable manufacturing companies in India. Till then, stay curious. See you soon.